I'm Phil from Phil's Train Layout. Today we're going to be doing a little bit more work on the expansion, and I hope you stay tuned and check out all the progress that's going on. So hi everybody, I'm back. I just thought I'd give you a little update on a little bit of the progress that I've been making on the layout, on the new addition. So I've got everything coming in here on the main line. And this is my main line right here. It comes around past the coffee and it comes around and it curves around at the back, and that is now exactly, and that is the track under there. You can't see it very well, but back under there is the track. That is where I still need to figure out how I can come out of there and get that new turnout attached in there, which will come out and attach to here. And then this is the extension that will eventually someday go through all my junk behind these cabinets through that wall and attach back to there. But at the moment, we are now, so everything else here, sorry, I'm kind of jumping around a little bit. So this here is where the track used to be. That sharp curve right there, that's where I was having the problems. Everything wanted to keep derailing and everything, and it just wasn't working very well. Oh, see, there's the remnants of one of them. So what I've done is I've taken that all up, and it used to branch off here to go into this little yard right here. So instead of doing that, I've now branch off here and switch off, and this one will follow up. And it connects to this half of the yard, which gives me a nice little spot for some extra storage. And this one here branches off, which is the new track that I just put in, just glued it down. And it'll go into this half of the yard, which also connects to this little storage spot right up in here. So lots of little extra storage, those little branch offs. So this piece right here, this here actually fits in there kind of nice. You know, I'll just have to touch up that little gap there right beside the little pond, but it used to be right here along that edge. So it actually worked out pretty good, and it, you know, kind of fits in there. Not too bad. Just put a little bit of bushes in there or something just to hide that seam. It should be working fine. This spot right here, this was the hill that came around. So I was having a little bit of a problem that it came down way too fast. So if you remember in the last video, I had put this piece of foam in, which was, I believe, it was just as thick as that. So I glued it on top and I cut slots in it just so to make it easier to cut and try to shape. But I think I didn't do too bad. You know, maybe a little bit more of touch-ups. Just with a really sharp knife, I'll just skim that edge, smooth it out just a little bit more, and then I'll put a coating on top just to smooth it out. Then it all transitions, you know, it'll transition right back in here. I'll put the cork bed back down, follow it up through, and then it'll just continue straight on there. And that completes that little section. So, detail wise, I think I will continue this hill right in here. I'll have it come out and maybe curve back like this, just so that you can see that opening and have that drain come in. I'll have that blend right through like that, come back up, and I'll continue this over to the wall here. And then just kind of have that, leave this section here open, because I'll want to add a little bit more to it later, because I'll put rail yards in there, and I'll have maybe a turnout right here just to go into the different yards, just as extra parking spots for different, you know, container loads or just extra cars, whatever, just hide back in there. But maybe this weekend I'll cut all this out so that it blends into what I've already done here. Have it curved back. Just blend back like this. Have it back up like that. And then maybe in this area right here, I don't know, maybe I can put a little business or something in there, just to try to fill up some of the spots in here. Now, you never know, because of that branch line, I might be able to use this as like coal. Have the coal bins along here, you know, a little coal depot, couple piles with a little loader loading up, or maybe a hopper drive, something in there, just to fill up the space and make it look busy, like a little active line. Well, that's it for the moment. I think I'm gonna head off to the train store and I actually ran out of rail joiners. Yeah, that's actually all that I have left. So if I can't do anything else, I need those rail joiners so I can continue playing a little bit this weekend. So this is the only time that I really get to play. So off I go. I will talk to everybody later once I get a little bit more done. Hey everybody, I'm back. So yesterday I had just worked on this section here, putting in the last piece of track for this section so that it comes around here. I still need to work on that section, trying to get the turnout underneath that hole on the side there connecting up, so I can connect the entire last bit of the main line. But today I think I'm going to work on this hill here, trying to get that all smoothed out, and that way I can get it all sanded and get this piece of track back on this decline, so I can get that set of track all completed again and try to get some functionality back so I can at least run a train. So I'm going to do a little bit of work on this, and then I'll come back and I'll show you the progress. Okay, so I'm back. Okay, so what I've done now is I have put the first coating of filler on this incline here, just to get it all filled in, and then I'll sand it down a little bit, and then I'll put a second coat on, make sure it's nice and smooth and gradual. What I did is I took an X-Acto knife and I just, you know, just shaved off the little spots that were high, just to make it a nice smooth gradual incline, just to make sure everything's looking pretty good. And so so far, if you look at the angle of the incline, it actually doesn't look too bad. Too bad. Not for me. It's not bad for me. So if you remember, along this edge here, there was that square looking edge, because that used to be the side of the track, side of the layout. So I started putting in a couple pieces of the tunnel. The new tunnel that's going to be in there, and the continuation of this hill right here. It's going to flow over and kind of blend somehow into the side of the wall. So I've got up a little piece of styrofoam here so I can blend this hill down, try to blend it in, and try to make the edge of that kind of transition down so it doesn't look so square. Sorry, I am actually a little out of breath at the moment. I just ran up and down the stairs. Should have taken a little breather before I videotaped this, but that's okay. So that is what I've done so far. I've got these couple pieces here glued in. These ones are just sitting here at the moment. And then I'll slowly build up the layers, cover that in, have a nice opening. This here, you know, I'm not sure exactly how I'm gonna work that one. Maybe I'll just blend this edge in so that a gradual hill comes down from the tunnel opening, or I'm not sure yet. I'll see how that comes about as I get the hill built in and put into place. So that is what I have done so far. I'm gonna let that dry and cure up. That way I can put the second coat on, smooth it out a little bit more, and then I'll do another video after I do a little bit more. Hey everybody, I'm back again. Well, I just thought I would give you a quick rundown of my layout without all the stuff on it. So I've completely cleared it all off while I was waiting for that to dry so I could put a second coat on it. So I thought maybe, you know what, I haven't cleaned my layout in quite a long time. So I took all the cars off of it. I took all the freight cars, everything, moved everything, gave it a quick vacuum just to clean it up a bit. And I had to do it anyway because there was a lot of work I needed to do and a bunch of stuff everywhere. So I will give you a quick rundown and a tour. I'll just scan through and I'll let you see everything. Probably better if there was a little music in the background. But I'm not going to sing for you, don't worry. And yes, for all us Canadians, yes, that is a Tim Hortons. You have to have Canadian Tim Hortons on a Canadian layout. Well, that's just a quick tour, just so that you can see everything that I've done, everything I'm working on, updates, all the things that I haven't finished yet. And I hope you enjoy it. Hope you like it. Any suggestions or comments, just leave a comment below. And you know, I'm quite new to this channel, and I'm new to doing videos, so I will talk to everybody soon. Hey everyone, I'm back. I just thought I'd give you a little update on some of the things that I was working on. So if you remember from the last update, I had just taken this piece of track out because of that sharp radius. I had redone and reformed that incline or decline, and I had just laid all of this track and attached it to the yards and attached it to the main line so that it comes around. I had been just starting to form this hill as part of the existing hill. And I'll get that all formed in. I've added a little bit of slope to the side of the decline, just so it blends in a little bit. And I'll probably add just a little bit more along there, just to blend that in, you know, so it blends in with the rest of that hill. I actually took one of the engines that I had that was DC, that one right there, because I was not able to use a six-wheel locomotive previously, and decided, you know what, I'm going to put in a DCC controller in it, and it actually runs fairly well. I've had it going all the way around the outside of the layout and all the way up here, in around the corner to where I haven't attached it under the hill yet, but all of these tracks work with it all the way up and all the way through. And from the back of the layout, it actually works perfectly on all of these tracks in here. So I am actually very happy with the way that's all been working so far. And I can actually use a larger locomotive now, which I'm very happy with. So some of the little things I was working on this morning, I just added just a little bit of filler just to try to smooth this out just a little bit more for the decline. That way I can sand it all and try to get rid of all the little humps and dips and try to make it as smooth as I can this time. This here was the old track. So what I've done is put a little bit of filler in there just to smooth out some of the divots that I had put in, taking the roadbed out. And I'm probably just going to make that a little roadway. Have it come through here, just right through this area here, and then have just like a maintenance road, and then put some kind of industrial little section right in here. Just try to give some more front detail and a little bit of workings up front. I might add a little hill right in here just to give a little bit of separation between the tracks. And when I had to put this little curve in here, that way it just kind of gives it a reason of why it's separated, and then have that track going to the little industrial here, and this one goes into the storage maintenance yard. So that is what I've done so far today. I'll probably do a little bit and just letting that just dry a little bit. And then I'll probably give this a quick little paint just so it blends in. I'm probably just going to use a brown base just to start with, just to give it a little coating to make it try to blend in a little bit and make it look like it has a little color before I start doing anything else to finish filling this in. And when I get a little bit more done, I'll give you a quick little update when that's done. I am back. Okay, so what I've done is I now have painted this little section just as a base coat, just to give it something as a dark color just underneath, so that when I put ground cover on and whatever, it'll blend in and make it a little better. And then I don't know, maybe I'll decide to put some little kind of buildings in here, like transformer boxes or something along that lines, just to give it something to look at in this area, because I seem to have a lot of just track, and it's kind of on the low end of exciting to look at. So maybe I'll figure something else out to put in there just to bring it to life. So I cut out and glued in just a piece of foam. Yes, I used the styrofoam with the styrofoam balls, but it doesn't cut actually that bad as long as you have a really sharp knife and you cut really slowly. It doesn't seem to work too bad. It's not as formable as like the pink insulation, but you know, it seemed to work out okay. So like with a nice sharp knife, you know, I can mold everything and, you know, not too bad. But I've got all that weighted down just to till the glue dries, and then I'll form that little tiny hill just as break up the scenery a little bit. So I added a little bit of detail and a little bit of shrubbery to this. I put in that little roadway that will come up into this industrial area of some sorts. I don't know, maybe I'll make it put some aggregate bins in there and make this like to fill hoppers and coal cars or whatnot, you know, gravel cars, stuff like that. Sorry, I'm not as fluent as on the names of all the different cars and everything as everyone else is, but I'm slowly learning, you know, as I go. You know, I'm slowly picking up the names as I'm trying to remember what everybody else calls them, so I don't sound like a, well, I can't say it, I actually am. I'm very unknowledgeable and I kind of learn as I go. But I put in that roadway right there, tried to blend it in like I did with the other section of road, and added a few more bits of shrubbery and everything else. So there is just that little tiny barrier that I glued in. I had a little strip of styrofoam that I had cut off something else that's gonna fill in that gap a little bit. And then once the glue's dried on that, then I'll just cut it and form the slope, and then But it kind of looks kind of neat just like that as a kind of like a barrier wall. But if I would have thought about that earlier, I might just have left it as like a stone wall there, just to break up some of the scenery. But that's a little late now, but you never know. I've been changing everything as I go anyway, so maybe I'll change that back and make that a stone wall. Or maybe I'll just put a great big fence along there, or a row of bushes or hedges, or to break up the track behind this scenery. So that is what I've done so far. And if anybody can figure out how to get that screw back in there, because I took it apart because some gravel got in there and it wouldn't turn anymore because it got stuck. So I took it apart, clean all the gravel out, and then I can't seem to get that screw to stay in as I put it all back together. And there's a spring that sits in there as contacts, and I just can't seem to get those little pins to stay in there as I put it all back together upside down. I'm thinking maybe I'll be able to do it with a couple magnets until I get it down in place to put the main screw back in, but just haven't attempted it yet. So, but that's everything that I've done at the moment. Add a couple more details. I just painted the edge of that while I had the paint out. Just try to blend in little tiny pieces here and there. So I will let you go from now. I'll update again once the glue dries and see what else I can get done. Well, thank you for watching Phil's train layout. The next couple of pictures here, just a little bit showing you what we did the next couple of days. And if you like the videos, please subscribe, please hit the bell icon, and we'll talk to you soon. Have a good day.